Good morning to all of you. Now we are going to see how we are going to connect a camera with our mobile app. So first we have to take example of the controls, what the controls we have taken. Just we have taken one button. When you click on the button, the camera is going to start. So this was a very simple application. So just I have taken one button on the linear layout. So first we have to initialize the layout. So here we have initialized layout activity underscore camera underscore example. We have taken one button and on the button ID is button 1. When the user click on the button, the camera should start to capture the video. So we have taken set on click listener method is equal to view dot on click listener is an interface. So for this interface we have to implement a method on click. So when you click on this, just we have to call a constant in the media store class action video capture. So action video capture, it is a class we have to import. The media store is a class which we want to import. So android.provider.mediastore, and in the media store class there is a constant action video capture. So when you run this code and when you click on the button, the camera is going to start. So this is a very simple example to start the camera. But suppose I want to capture the images, or suppose I want to capture the video, then there is a different code. Now we are going to see that code also. So simply we want to suppose start the camera, just we have to write a single line of sentence, that is action video capture. Now the next code, that is how suppose I want to capture the images, or suppose I want to capture the video. So I want an image view. So let's check first the layout. Now this is the layout where I want to drag and drop the image view. So we have taken one image view. I have taken the ID as image view also, and one button, click here to capture the image using camera. So this code is going to start the camera and it is going to capture the images, and it is going to store that images also. Now we see the code one by one. The class name is camera, extends app compact activity. Now we have taken a button, and second we have taken image view. Now why we have taken the image view? Because once you capture the image, I want to display that image on the screen also. So we have taken the image view. So whatever the image we are going to capture, that should be displayed on the screen. So intent is a layout. Now we have taken the request code as 1, public static final integer request permission code for the camera. Now we have taken the activity initialization. So set content view. Set content view, it is a method we are going to call, and r.layout.activity camera. Second, that is we have taken a button. So after that we have taken image view. Now we have written one method, that is enable permission, runtime permission. And when you click on the button, we have taken intent is equal to new intent, android.provider.mediastore action image capture. This is the constant present in the class media store. So this is the media store class. You can import either, you can import a class just we have seen in the previous example, otherwise you can directly write the code like this also, android.provider.mediastore. And after that we have to start the activity for result. We have to start the intent, and the request code is by default 7. This is optional. Now here is the code for enable runtime permission. This is the method we have called over here. Now next method, that is protect the void on activity result. Now on activity result is nothing but we are going to capture the data, and we want to store that into a particular folder. That folder name is data. Now protected void, this is the method name. We are passing the request code, result code and intent. Now the request code is 7, that is everything is okay, and result code is result okay. So this is the result code, result underscore okay. Then I want to store that image as a bitmap. So bitmap variable name is bitmap is equal to data dot extra dot get data. This is the name of the folder. Now image view dot set image bitmap, and I want to set that for the image view. Now this is the code where we want to set the image captured. So image view is a control, on that control image is displayed. Now, public void enable runtime permission. Now here is the toast.make_test. Camera permission allows us to access the camera. And toast.length_long_show. Now after that there is a method on request permission result. Now I'm going to use a switch. So integer request code, that is RC, string permission, and integer permission result. Now the first case, that is request permission code. Now if permission result dot length is greater than 0 and permission result is 0, then package manager dot permission granted. Now here we are going to check the permission granted code with these variables. Then we want to display in the toast message as permission granted. Now your application can access the camera. If there is something wrong, in order to initialize it, we can make the toast as permission cancelled. Now your application cannot access the camera. And I'm going to break this case. So this was the permission for the permission. So this was the code for camera. Now suppose I want to run this. You want to make the change over here. You can make this as a, when you run this code, you will get the output. Now this was the code for the camera example. When you click on the click here to capture image camera, it is going to run as the camera, but we have not initialized everything. So you can get the camera, you can get this app, and you can try out this code. It is going to capture the images and it is going to display the images also. So this was the code for capturing the images and capturing the video also. Suppose I want to take the as a video, then here we want to get the video view. That's it. So you can use this for the either capturing the images or you can capture the video also. So this was the end of this session. We have seen the camera example. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.